So, hello. My name is Robert Ulrich. I'm a student at the KIT, and my work was supervised by Benedict Kempten, which you probably already know, and also by Jürgen Ehringer and Joachim Liepert from the Institute of Hydrology, which aren't here today. So the topic is about hydrologic analysis and how we can use Semantic Media Wiki for it. So first I will give a short motivation and what exactly we are analyzing, then what's the current problem, and how are the related works to this topic, and then how we can solve it with SMB and semantic technology. And yeah, at the end you will get a little demo about it. So the motivation, probably you see it already on the picture. So it's about water power. So sustainable and renewable energy sources are a hot topic in Germany, especially since the events of Fukushima and the win of the Green Party in Baden-Württemberg. And mostly you hear about solar and wind power in the public discussion, but there's also hydroelectricity. It's the most used renewable energy source in the world for electric power generation, so it's about 16%, and in Germany it's only about 3.5%. So the question is there any potential left? Are there any sweet spots where we can possibly build some new water power plants? And as you can see on the map, there are the existing power plants plotted, and they are mainly based in Bavaria and Baden-Württemberg, which makes it interesting to analyze it in Baden-Württemberg especially. So what is the problem? There are already existing studies, but they have some shortcomings. They are not extendable. As you can see, they only cover a certain area. You cannot extend it. You just get a stack of paper, maybe something about 80 slides. And they only cover this area. They describe the model, the parameters they have used, and then that's all. You cannot extend it for other areas. You cannot change the parameters. You cannot extend the model itself. And after all, you don't get any details about the stuff. So you only see these sections and you get aggregated results for the sections. But if you actually want to know if there's any potential near your house at the river, so you don't get it from the studies. And after all, you don't get machine-readable data. So usually there's only the paper and that's it. And yeah, so what have others done? There's on one side Dropedia, which some probably know. It's one deliverable of the SMART project and is about the integrated water resource management scenario. And there it's usually about water demand and supply, considering social, ecological, and economical aspects. So hydrology is only one small part of this, but it was used to collect the knowledge of different domain experts and share it. And on the other side, there is an actual study about the water power potential in Baden-Württemberg. It's about the catchment area of the Neckar, and we will use this as a comparison. So how is it usually done? So usually you have a lot of data, which means you have a digital elevation model, you have a model of the river area, you have the hydrological data, which is usually provided as shapefiles, as CSV, or even as plain text. And you have to collect all this data and combine them. And afterwards, you calculate the line potential, which is somehow an upper bound and describes the total energy stored in the river system. And afterwards, you take a model of an actual water power plant, which usually means you take a runoff power plant and then subtract the losses which actually occur to the turbine, the generator, and the transformator. And afterwards, you model the economical potential, since not everything what we can build is economically feasible, and especially in Germany, there is the Renewable Energy Act, which states how much you get for the energy you are producing. And afterwards, the results are presented as described as in form of a paper. And what's missing in this paper is the actual technically implementation. So according to the pictures and to other studies, it's usually ArcGIS which is used and Excel to generate graphics and other stuff. So now how we are going to do it and to improve it with the semantic technologies and semantic media wiki. So first we have the requirements. Obviously we have to calculate the potential. This is a must have. And then we want to design a system which is extendable and which gives us a detailed presentation and which exports the data in a machine readable form, most desirably as linked data. So here's the basic use case, where you can see the domain experts, which come from different scientific domains, like engineers, hydrologists, economists, ecologists. They draft the basic model of the analysis, and they provide the data. And obviously, those domain experts aren't experts in semantics or semantic media wiki, so we need an administrator or a programmer which converts the data to RTF and imports it into the system and also implements the model. So for the domain experts, there is teamwork required. So not all domain experts know which parameters are to set. So wiki is really suitable for this. And we have the two phases, the preparation, where the system is built up, and then the usage, where the users actually set the parameters, view the results, and evaluate them. So now how can we solve this with Semantic Media Wiki? So we have basically two parts. On the one side, we have the Dribbble store, where the original data is loaded in. So the different data types are converted to RDF and stored into the Dribbble store. So we afterwards only have to deal with RDF and don't have to care about shapefiles and the other stuff anymore. To this, there's the Sparkle endpoint, which provides the data export and a little script, which exports the data from the Dribbble store as HTML or as XML. And on the other hand, we have the Semantic Media Wiki. So I basically wrote an extension which extends the Lua functionality of Scribundo. So maybe this is a hint to the discussion today we had. And this provides some additional functions to the Scribundo modules. And this is especially doing ask queries, doing Sparkle queries, doing Sparkle update queries. So you actually can query the wiki within the Lua language and you can write back data via Lua. So then there's the module block, which is actually provided by Scribundo. This is an extra namespace. And there are pages which are somehow similar to libraries where you can write functions and you can execute them. And this is all in the front end. The user can see this and he can edit everything in these pages. So this is somehow like Visual Basic to Excel. And in the current implementation, I have five main modules, which is the hydrology module. This calculates line potential, then the technical potential is calculated, and the economically, and afterwards the view module retrieves the data for viewing in the wiki. The cube model is just to make the storage easier, since this looks like a pipeline, and every module reads the data as a data cube and writes it back as an RDF data cube. And on the top, we have the templates and the pages, and this is the only thing a normal user has to work with. So usually users will only view the pages and set the parameters to the model via templates, which is quite easy. So now the big question is, how does it work as designed? So I imported the data and I implemented the model into the wiki and I calculated the results. And as you can see on the upper picture, the green result is from the NECA study and the red result is from my. So you see there are 380 kilowatt from the original power plant, which is really there. And then my result is something about 2200. And the question is, why does this result come up? So there's a huge gap. And obviously, why should someone build a power plant there if there is some meters further up the stream, a much better place? So one reason is the different model. So the hydrology model is a little bit different than the original from the NECA study. So I did something different to the economical value, and I don't select on the technical power installed, but on the net private value, which comes out. So, but this doesn't matter that much. And there's the different data used. So I used the digital elevation model. And as you can see on the lower slide, there are two types of digital elevation models. There's the terrain model, which really follows the ground. And then you have the surface model, which just includes houses and trees. And as you can see up there, there's a town near the point, and this means there are high houses. And then you get huge height differences when the town ends. And this is why the point is located at this position. But if I take the values from the green, so the discharge and the height difference, I come to 350 kilowatts, so it's in the same range. So the model works, but the data is a little bit focused on this place. So the next thing is this expandable? So setting parameters is easy, as we have seen yesterday in the tutorials. So you can just edit the page and set the template parameters. The integrating new data, this works. You just have to convert your data into RDF and load it into the Drupal store. So probably this isn't a huge problem. If you have someone who is into semantic web technologies and can do this for you, and then there's changing the model. And currently this is quite difficult since Scribundo is a relatively new extension and there are some pitfalls. So you only get a stack trace on the page and debugging is only done via a lock function. And obviously for a normal user, this isn't an option to really change something. And the next part is the presentation. How does it look? We obviously get more details, and afterwards you will see in the demo how it really looks like. So don't care about the screenshots here. And for the NECA study, you see you have only some certain points with some information about it, and it's quite difficult to get any more details out of this. And for the wiki system, it's easily to be customized, so you can view different and other data additional to the already existing data, and you also can import other data and show it. So now there's the data export, and there's, with the setup, one possibility: just make your Sparkle endpoint public. This comes for free with this system, so someone can query your data and use it itself. And then we have a little script which provides the data as RDF XML if queried correctly or if viewed with a browser as HTML. You see the screenshot on this side, and it's just a describe query on the URI and resolved and returned to the user. And since we can do Sparkle queries, we also can import data in a sense of linked open data. So the Sparkle function has an optional parameter where you can specify the Sparkle endpoint and pull in new knowledge from other systems. So in this case, I have pulled in the administrative areas, which are important for legal constraints and where the important persons who are responsible for this are sitting. And this is actually imported on the fly via Sparkle from LinkGeo data. So basically, yes, we can calculate results with better data. It would probably give better results. So it's not really done. So we have to implement a higher resolution digital elevation model expandability. So probably in the future, when the Scribundo extension gets a little bit easier to use, and then the detailed presentation, this works fine, and machine readable data works fine too. So overall, the system works as planned. And there are some pitfalls, especially for hydrology analysis and geoinformation systems. There are missing vocabularies, so the basic geo-vocabularies which come from the semantic web community aren't really suitable for hydrology and GIS topics. So, for example, points are always represented in the WGS 84 projection, and in Germany we usually use Gauss-Krüger, and you can't represent it with current vocabularies. And another pitfall was the performance of the triple store. So this wasn't my main topic, but yeah, it took a lot of time to make it work, since the original digital elevation model had about something 130 million triples, and this was much too much for my triple store and my machine, and so I had to cut it down. And you will still see in the demo that it's not that fast. And then there's the other part, the maturity of other tools. Especially there's a lot of research going on in the GIS science concerning semantic web, and most tools are still in development and are difficult to set up and to get them running. So yeah, you spend a lot of time to try it out and yeah, check afterwards how it doesn't work. But after all, SMV rocks. So together with Lua, you can do the really nasty stuff. And yeah. So now to the short demo. So maybe let's search some river by the administrative area, which is imported from LinkGeo data. So hopefully this works now. Yes. So you see it, all rivers which are located in the district Möcklingen. And we, for example, pick this now. And this is the basic system. So you have a map here where the river itself is printed. And on the right side, you have a diagram where you get the basic data just by moving over with the mouse. So you can really see what values are at a specific point, so it updates the map. So you actually really see where the point is and what data is calculated for this point. and afterwards you get a list with feasible points where you can actually consider building a water power plant, and you obviously get some additional info about the river itself, the name, the length, the total potential and the total energy which could be produced there, and then you have the administrative areas, and at the bottom you get a navigation box where you can follow the river system. So these are the inlets to the river body, and this is the outlet, so you can just follow the river step by step. So as you see now, this is probably taking a little bit longer, since it reads a lot of data from the Dribbble store. So there you are at the next, and so let's get back and change some parameters so you can see that this works. So there is, for example, the price after 20 years. So the Renewable Energy Act only states prices for 20 years, and afterwards you have to sell your electricity on the market, and you probably assume a price of 20 cent per kilowatt, and maybe someone else is considering 25. So I need to be locked in. So we execute the actual calculation. This takes a while. So here you see the net private value of at this point, and with the previous parameters you see another value. So yes, you can change the parameters, and there are a lot of more parameters. You can see the description in the templates, so what you actually can change and what you can view, and you also can add additional data up here. For example, if you are interested in the raw height from the digital elevation model, you can just add it. So what I've done here, I've given the number of the river, and then the value of the measurement, which is stored in the data cube, and give it a label. Refresh. So obviously something went wrong. here is the problem. Now you can see the values are added here too in the graph, and you see the original height values from the digital elevation model. And the yellow one are smooth and used for the actual calculation. So yeah, thanks for listening. You can see on the prototype, just use the URL and smvcon as password and login. So yeah, that was my presentation about hydrological stuff with SMV. And yeah, thanks for listening. Are there any questions?
Yeah, I have, two questions. I really very like the system from technological point of view, but it seems odd that you have used first wikis, because what kind of community there are, and secondly Lua, which is seems to be used when you have a very big system without access to the actual code, and you put this code on the wiki, so that new functionality will be added. So why wikis and why Lua?
So the original thought was that the different domain experts can change the parameters and can add information to the system. This wasn't evaluated in this work, since you need a lot of people to work with. So if you get 10 people out of 100 which understands the basic topic of SMV, so it wasn't just enough time to evaluate the community part of this. And it's just showing that it's possible in SMV, and in the next step it should be evaluated if other people can contribute to the wiki, what different knowledge they will add. And it's still a wiki, so this is only the basic functionality, and they can use it as a wiki and add other stuff, descriptions about the administrative districts, at the contact information, or people which actually have a power plant at a certain site can change the parameters, since they really know them. And yeah, the Lua part is the original idea was that the user really can change the model or extend it. So if maybe after 2 or 3 years the Renewable Energy Act is outdated and replaced with something new, which already happened for the NECA study, then you have the problem that the study isn't valid anymore for the economical part. You really have to adapt the model and change, for example, the prices. And this is easily when you have Lua and can just change the code. And
this part with inserting SMW queries into Lua, have you developed it? Is it possible? What's the state of art here?
So the normal Lua functions in Scribundo, they are relatively restricted. So you have to tweak for the timeouts, and they are built up with security. And they don't allow query SMV. So I've read some mails from SM James or SMW James, which already seems to be working on. But half a year ago, this wasn't really a topic. And so I digged into Lua, and Lua and Scribundo is extendable like MediaWiki itself. So you can really provide new functions to it. And the new part here really is that not only additional information can be retrieved from other data sources, so you can also store the information in the triple store. So the most calculation isn't really represented in the wiki directly. So the model of the river area is just stored in the triple store and retrieved and written back by Lua.